Well, wave to them, man, big smiles on your faces. Biggest smiles ever, huge, huge smiles. Get those huge smiles out. People are boarding, let's go ahead and point out them. They're sitting down. Some people aren't, those people in the front are not sitting. Point to them, point you. Talking to you. That's, all right, good, they're sitting down. All right, let's go ahead and point out some emergency exits. There are two emergency exits on the airplane in the front of the plane, in the front, over each front door. You can exit, that's right. There are also two in the back, that's not good. All right, and then there's two directly behind you in the back, and the two in the front. And don't forget about the two over the wings. The two over the wings, and then the two in the front. The two in front, the two in the back, and then the two over the wings. That makes six exits, actually six times. It's actually 12 exits. 12, 12, on your hands, 12. 12, 12 exits. 12, 12. Show us 12, 12, number of 12. Show me 12 on your hands. 12 exits, there we go, good. But the two on the wing and then minus the one in the front, that's okay, don't worry about it. Let's go ahead and fasten your seatbelt. Take a little bit of class. Firmly secure yourselves in, lock yourselves in. That's it, great. Lock yourselves in, that's awesome. All right, fasten your seatbelts. Good. Turn off all electronic devices, even though they say you can use them, but you can't. I'm not even sure. Turn them off. No smoking. I don't even know why they even tell you this. You can't smoke. You cannot smoke. You can't smoke anything. You cannot smoke anything on the plane. No, 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 no. No pipes or cigars or cigarettes. When's the last time you saw somebody smoke something on an airplane? That's right. And talking of that, no smoking in the bathroom, lavatory, the restroom, the toilet, the restroom, the washroom, I don't care what you call it. You cannot smoke in there. Yeah, you can't smoke. And you cannot disarm, remove, or tamper with the smoke detectors. No, we're going to know it's you. Like, you really think you're going to get away from it? Walk out the door and you're like, it looked inconspicuous. Like, ooh, we didn't know it was you. You were in there. But you were in there by yourself smoking, weren't you? You were smoking and we're going to catch you, so don't do it. Don't do it. And we're going to show a movie on board. Movies are all free. I don't care what kind of movie you watch. They're all free. Drinks are free. Drinks are free. If you don't drink alcohol, you won't drink it. But they're free. Everything's free. Free food. We're going to even order pizzas. That's right. Pizzas will be delivered in the sky for you. Handmade, beautiful pizzas. We're going to hand toss them as well. We're going to make any pizza of your kind. You can make them. And you know what? We can even make sushi. We're going to make sushi like a samurai chef. We're going to make them in the back. When's the last time you were on an airplane you had hand-rolled sushi rolls, any kind of rolls? We're going to make them for you. That's right. That's great. And any kind of food. We're even making barbecue in the back of the airplane for you. That's right. So we're making, oh yeah, we got a big old grill in the back. There's where we can smoke. We can smoke by the grill, but nowhere else. That's right. All right. It's highly unlikely, but if it's a mass comes down in front of you, it's a loss of cap of pressure. Put the mask on. I'm so sorry. I gotta focus. Put the mask on first and breathe normally. If the person next to you needs any help, give them a hand. Help them out. Help them out. Help them out. Good. All right. Good. Have a seat for me, flight attendants. Have a seat. Have a seat, flight attendants. Have a seat. Everybody scoot on down. Flight attendants, have a seat. Be comfortable. Scoot all the way down to first class. First class, scoot all the way down to first. Oh, that, oh, this is coach. This is coach. This is coach. That's okay. To the left is the left. All the way to the left is first. All the way to the left is first. There we go. Did you drop an earring or something? Did you drop an earring or something? Somebody dropped some shiny or something, like an earring backing or something. Or something on the floor. I'm not really sure what that was. I wish we knew. Sit up in your seats in 3, 2. 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. Back down. Give him a hand. Let me hear you. Come on. Yeah, this is my job. You guys want to keep it going?
Yeah. Yep.
Let's have a little guitar hero competition. When I open up their eyes, they're all going to think they're rock stars in a guitar hero competition. No running, jumping, or leaping. Have fun, but you cannot run, jump, or leap around. Much like the last segment, you would stay standing upright, but no running, jumping, or leaping. This is an air guitar competition. The judges are out there. You're going to win about $5,000 in cash prizes for the winner tonight of this tonight's competition. Make it $4,000. Anyway, so when I open up their eyes, listen carefully. You all have long, flowing hair like rock stars. I mean, you talk like rock stars. You have accents like rock stars. I don't know what that means. But you guys think you're rock stars on three. I'll open your eyes slowly. One, take a deep breath. Two, all the way up in your seats, all the way up in your chairs. And three, eyes open. Let me hear you out there. Give it up for them. Come on, make some noise. Rock stars, stand up. Grab your guitars, rock stars. Grab your guitars. Let's start tuning the guitars a little bit. Fix your hair. Fix your rock star hair. Fix that hair. Whip it back. There we go. Good. Whip that hair back. All right. There we go. Good. All right. Let's start this competition. Go ahead. Sing up right there for me. Don't run around. Sing up right there. Sing both feet on the floor. There we go. Ladies, have a seat for a second. Ladies, just the guys, just the guys. Go ahead, guys, show us how
to do it.
Nice job. Okay, Jeff, be careful. Right, guys, have a seat. Have a seat, guys. Have a seat. Oh, I'm sorry, Marcus. That was good. Mauricio, that was pretty awesome. Ladies, stand up. Show us how it's done. Come on, I can hear you out there. That's awesome. Have a seat, ladies. That was awesome. That's going to be hard to follow. Have a seat over there for me. There we go. Good. Be careful. Watch your step there. All right. Good. Everybody's good. And three, two, one. Okay, I have something planned I've got to do for you. I'm running out of time, but I'm going to throw something extra in there. Would you guys say? Yes? Okay. After what I just saw, I've got to do this one thing, and I don't want to waste any time. I'm going to get right to it. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to introduce to you one of the most talented people in the world. The person I'm about to introduce to you thinks that they are the greatest puppeteer. They think that their left and right hand are puppets. Listen carefully. Jeff, you are the greatest puppeteer artist in the world. You're not a ventriloquist. You're a puppeteer. So we're going to see the words come out of your mouth. You're not trying to hide it. Your left and right hand are puppets. Everybody else on stage are your biggest fans. The audience, they love you. Now, I'm going to play something in the sound system. You think they're your words. So if you know them, you'll say them with what you hear. If you don't, you'll just try and lip sync what you hear. You understand? Nod your head. You're a puppeteer doing the greatest performance of your life for your biggest fans. Here we go. One, take a deep breath. Two, slowly sit up in your seats, all the way up in your chairs. Slowly get that energy. You guys are here to watch. And folks, would you please welcome the greatest puppeteer artist in the world here on Disney Wonder. Let me hear you out there. Thanks for that. You've traveled around the world doing this show. You're not a ventriloquist, so we're going to see your words come out of your mouth. Most of the time you perform in front of a curtain. No, not for them. These are your fans. They want to see the magic behind the curtain. That's you.
I understand, and I am the best. So
that's awesome. Now, what's this puppet's name over here, John?
It's Jimbo.
Jimbo. Okay, what about this one?
Katrina.
Katrina and Jimbo. Do you swap them out? I mean, you look surprised that you even have them.
I'm ambidextrous, so either way.
Okay, either way. Oh, I mean, you use different puppets besides Jimbo or... Nobody's ever answered that way before, Jeff. I've never seen... Okay, so you can switch the puppet's hands, but do you have different puppets, or are they always with you, these two?
I have many different puppets.
Okay, all right. Well, I'm glad we cleared that up. All right, now, you guys ready to see him? You're his biggest fans, and you guys out there. Well, before the show, he whispers something in each puppet's ear, just like good luck or something. He whispers anything in the puppet's ear, something just for him and the puppet, not for you to know, sorry. All right, a little mysterious there, okay. And then the puppets stare at the audience. They stare at the audience. Puppets stare. And you can, Jeff stares at the audience. Let the show begin.
I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the bandango? Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me. Galileo. 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 Galileo.
Tonight. Tomorrow night, as I said, is the theater show for all the families that want Disney Theater. My own kids help me write a lot of what I do. Some of the show at the beginning is very similar, but the middle, it's a lot different, and it's for all ages. You're going to have an absolute blast. So I hope to see you tomorrow night for the all family show. When I'm not doing my show, I teach people how to use a technique, and it's really cool because I do lectures of corporations and motivational programs where not only I'm really revealing the secrets of how this is done. And I have some exciting news that will be in the agenda, will be in your navigator. But on our last C-Day, which is on Sunday, I'm actually going to do a very special seminar for the adults where I'm not only going to reveal the secrets of how to do this, but I'm going to teach you how to do it, and then I'm going to hypnotize the entire crowd to lose weight and reduce stress on autopilot. So what do you guys think of that? Yes? So that it should be on the agenda for, and it'll be in your navigator, as Peter's told you every day, check your navigator. That'll be on the agenda for our C-Day. It'll be in the Buena Vista Movie Theater at 1 p.m. on Sunday. But don't worry, like I said, all that information will be delivered to you, and I hope to see you there. Friends, without these people behind me, the show tonight would have never happened. When I do wake them up, please let them know how much fun you guys had with them being the stars of the show.